I'm going to show you how to add a timer on top of your Google form. Google form by default does not provide this facility, but using extended forms add-on you can add this feature. In your screen you can see a simple math test which I have created, and I have added a couple of questions to this form. I've also made this form as a quiz. Each question is allocated 5 points, and total number of points allocated to the whole form is 10 points. Now that our form is configured and up and running, let's add the add-on. So to add that, click on the three dotted menu, click on add-ons, and the add-ons marketplace will appear. In the search bar, type extended or just a couple of letters in extended, and the extended forms add-on should appear right away. The add-on is displayed on your screen, extended forms. Click on the add-on and click on the install button. Once you click on the install button, it will ask you a couple of permissions in order to access your form. Provide all the permissions and you are done. Once you have installed the add-on, a new menu will appear on the top menu. Click on add-ons, click on extended forms, and you will see configure, about, and help. Simply click on configure and you will see a small window which has popped up from the right hand side. Let it load, and the first thing which you will see is connecting your form to extended forms. So let's toggle this button. It will take a couple of seconds and your form should be ready. Right away there are a couple of things you will notice. So if you scroll down of your form, you will see an extra field has been added. This is to keep track of a unique ID which is filled programmatically by the add-on itself, so you don't need to worry about it. All we need to do is not to delete it, otherwise your scores will not be recorded in extended form dashboard. And you also see there is an attention needed. So this form collects respondent's email address which is not compatible with extended forms. So either you can click on sync or you can click on your settings. Make sure all the checkboxes are unchecked on the general screen. If you are using G Suite, there will be another checkbox under sign in requirement which limits the login to your organization. Make sure that is also unchecked. Since all the checkboxes are unchecked, I am going to click on save, and I'm going to click on sync as well just to be double sure. Once my form is configured properly, you can see the settings. This form is shared with anyone with a link, and you can copy the link from here, and you can send an email or send a WhatsApp or however you want to communicate to your users. Then there is a time limit. Make sure you set it according to your requirement. Let's set it for 5 minutes. And this is how many number of attempts you want to restrict your users to. Let's just keep it 1 and click on save. Once you have saved your settings, now your extended form is connected. Let's preview the form. Click on preview and it will open a new tab. You can see a welcome screen which shows the form title and also shows a logo and also shows the username. Since I'm already logged in as a user, it is not asking me for any login. Directly I'm seeing the welcome screen. But if you copy the form link, the share form link, and send it to anybody, they will be required to log in. Now let's get started. On the top you will see the timer has already started. The logo is displayed on the left, and on the right the email of the user has been displayed. Let me attempt the questions. So let's say 12 or 10, whichever is right, and then go to the next one and submit. So notice that once you submit the form, V means extended forms automatically captures the submission. And let's go back to our form and let's go to form settings. The form settings model will pop up, close it off. You will see a newly dashboard which has been created for you. It shows all the forms which has been connected. Let's go to the forms menu. I have tested a couple of forms before this demo, so those are being shown here. You can also see other options like creating a team, upgrading your quota with a billing option and other settings. On the top, you can see number of responses quota being used by you. Currently, you are using 0 out of 100. That means 100 users can respond to your forms. If you are testing your form using the preview button, that response is not counted in the quota. Let's go to the form which we just created. And under the responses section, you will see who has responded, in how many seconds, and what is the final score. It's also possible to delete this response if required. On the top, you will see a number of options. You can actually toggle the accept response. So this form will stop accepting new responses. You can send this form to Google Classroom. You can attach it to your existing classes and create a new classwork. You can open up the form settings, which is similar to one which we showed earlier. You can also send invitations from this panel. So you just type the email address of your user and send an invitation. This is a preview form button, so it is used for testing your forms. This is the share form link, so if you copy it, you can send it. So I'm just going to paste it here, and you can see the whole form ID has been shown. Let's go back to our dashboard. And then there are a couple of more options, like visiting your original Google form, and then transferring this form ownership to another user. So this completes this part of the tutorial. In the next tutorial, we will see how to create new teams, how to upgrade your billing quota, how to set your branding. That's it for today. Thank you.